equation to set up, but it was rate of change is proportional to the population amount. So that's the equation we got. We have solved this before, so I'm just going to scroll up real fast to our first problem in this section. We're not going to go through all the steps again, but here was that calculus. We separated things out, so y is on one side, non-y's or x is on the other. There was no x's, so it was pretty easy. We just had ln y was our antiderivative, added constants, and we got down to, I'm going to go right down to this bottom line. So I'm going to use that as the solution. So we don't need to redo the calculus on this one. So I'm just going to go dot, dot, dot from above. We got y equals a e to the kt. So now we need some initial conditions. So here are the conditions. In any given year, the number of cases are reduced by 20%. And if there are 10,000 cases today, how long until 1,000? All right, so each year, the number of cases are reduced by 20%. And if there are 10,000 today, how long until there are 1,000 cases? So I have not actually said what units of time that we're going to measure in. So given this information, what unit of time should I use?
Probably years.
So it makes sense to use years, because the only information we got is in years. And so t is in years. Now, it was a choice we made. I could have gone months, but then we would have had to convert a little bit. It would have been every 12 months we would reduce by 20% instead of every year. All right, so t is in years. How in the world can I use this 20% reduction right here? So we want to be careful. We can create some data points. We can say if there's 100 people today, how many would there be in 1 year if we reduced by 20%?
80.
So I can basically create two data points. That's one of the straightforward ways to do this. So let's go ahead and do that method. So you can say however many there are. We could even go, hey, there's 10,000 today, and in a year there'll be 8,000. That would be a 20% reduction. So I'm just thinking 100 down to 80 would be easier. So t is in years, and we're going to create points. Actually, let's use the 10,000 today. Now we count in years, usually we'll say today, that'll be time zero. So we're starting our timer today. And the 20% reduction means 8,000 cases in 1 year, which is t equals 1. So use these two points right here. So our first point is 10,000, 0, 10,000. And of course, this is t, y of t. And our second point is 1 year, 8,000 cases. So use these two data points and this y equals a e to the kt and figure out what is a and what is k. You should be able to get both of those values.